The Ticklish Kid by Pedro Pablo Sacristán. Pete Sparks was a sensitive boy. So sensitive that even his hair was ticklish.
No, don't come near me. Don't touch me. Please, no, no!
You only had to touch his hair a little bit, and he would burst out laughing. And when his ticklish laughter started, no one could make him stop. So Pete grew up used to strange situations. When his granny's friends came to visit,
oh gosh, what am I gonna do? They're gonna touch me!
He would always end up in stitches because there was never any shortage of little old ladies rubbing his head and saying,
how cute! Stop! Stop touching me! Stop touching me!
Windy days were the worst. With Pete on the ground, paralyzed by laughter whenever the breeze blew through his locks, which incidentally were pretty long, because at the barber shop, no one could manage to cut his hair due to the nonstop giggling. To see Pete laugh, as well as being great fun, was terribly contagious. When Pete started feeling ticklish, everyone ended up in endless laughter. And they just had to give up whatever they were doing.
Child is so funny.
I've never seen such a funny child.
That kid's a riot.
As Pete grew up, people started to ban him from certain places. Some activities are serious business and cannot be done amid gales of laughter. So Pete tried everything to control his ticklishness. He tried wearing 1,000 different hats. He used ultra-strong hairspray and gels. He even tried shaving his head. One time, he went on a yoga course to see if he could bear the tickling by learning to relax himself.
Oh. Oh, this didn't work either. Oh, darn it.
But nothing worked. It was impossible. He wanted, with all of his heart, to just be a normal boy. So as time went on, he began to feel sad and ill-fated for being different. This went on until one day, in the street, he met a special clown. The clown was very old and could hardly walk, but when he saw Pete in tears, he went to cheer him up. The clown didn't take long to make Pete laugh, and then they started to talk. Pete told him about his ticklish problem, and he asked the clown,
how can such an old man be a clown?
I have no one to replace me,
said the clown.
And I have a very serious job to do.
Pete looked at him, surprised, and thought,
serious? A clown? What do you mean?
Come, I'll show you,
said the clown. So the clown took Pete all over the city, to many hospitals, shelters, and schools. They were full of children who were sick or orphaned. Children with very serious problems. But as soon as they saw the clown, their faces changed completely and lit up with a smile. Their short while spent with the clown changed everything for them. But that day was even more special, because in every show, Pete's ticklishness would inevitably make an appearance, and his contagious laughter would end up with the kids laid out on the floor, dying with laughter.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.